Dear students of Reddit, what the worst teacher you've ever had? My second grade teacher. I always had terrible penmanship, but we had to write a report on a book about an animal. I picked penguins. The next day she called me up in front of the class. She said my report was so bad and illegible that she was going to have to tell the principal and that I was going to be expelled from second grade. I bawled my eyes out because I thought I was going to never be allowed to go to school again and knew I'd get my ass whooped when I got home. She told a second grader that he was going to get kicked out of school because of penmanship. She was just a terrible human. Not currently a student, but when I was, I had a first grade teacher who, whenever she caught me chatting with another student, when I was supposed to be listening, would yank on my ear. On the flip side, in 10th grade I was in the hospital for a few weeks. Once I returned to school, my language arts teacher stayed after school every day to help me catch up until I was back on track with the other students in the class. Fluid dynamics professor. On an exam he had a true/false section. +1 for correct, -2 for wrong or empty. Question whatever. An inviscid fluid means it has zero viscosity. About 2/3 of the class marked true. He marked it wrong for everyone, because you only assume a fluid is inviscid. I sent him scans from the textbook, the Merriam-Webster dictionary definition, and the Oxford dictionary definition. He would not budge for anyone. Some of my Aero friends laughed at the dude. My current professor in my nursing program. My cohort is made up of 74 students and we all have her for the same class. Not one person has anything positive to say about this woman. During lecture she only reads the PowerPoint slides as they are without elaborating or teaching about the subjects of the slides. She then tries to relate what the topic of the slides are to her clinical experience in the hospital. But her stories are convoluted, distracting from the actual topic, and very off-tangent. She basically talks about herself as God's gift to anyone who has had her as a nurse. She is by far the biggest narcissist I have ever encountered. I have never met anyone who has thought so highly of themselves before. When it comes time for her exams, many students do very poorly because the material on the exams are often not covered in her lecture. There is almost zero relation of what she says in class and the questions she asks on the exam. Reading the chapters multiple times has proven to be an ineffective method in preparation for her exams. When students go to her office hours for help, she never gives any rationale to any answers on exams or slide questions. She says to read the book. Many of us question her knowledge of the subject she is teaching. It becomes suspect when not even a theory can be given. I understand the concept of students learning on their own, but she can't even point the one seeking help in the right direction. On a side note, she claims she can smell a patient bleeding internally. Internally? Health and safety teacher, late 50s early 60s maybe, he was very much like Ozzy Osbourne. Stutter, forget unforgettable things, begin to vacantly stare into space sometimes halfway through conversation. Worst of all was the contradiction. Oh lord. He would say write this down. This is the best answer explanation for this question, then skip 20 minutes forward to when he was marking the questions and a meltdown would ensue. Because we wrote the wrong answer and he didn't know where we possibly could have got it from. A math teacher that also worked with the cheerleaders. The teacher gave extremely preferential treatment to the cheerleaders. They got out of class anytime for any reason. No homework on their menses, we all knew, because they would tell the teacher directly while in class, but the other girls in class would complain about not receiving the same treatment. The teacher was highly disorganized, and rarely actually taught anything. It was mostly do this page in class, do this page for homework. She would gather the cheerleaders at her desk during class for little POW wows on hemp lotion, MLM in school, I kid you not. Went in one day, after struggling on problems and said, look I figured it out. Her response? Well let me give you a cookie. Got sent to detention for telling her to fuck herself. She also called me out twice in class for being a pagan. She really liked to harp on that. Later on she was fired for having sex in her classroom, not with a student though. Vindication at last. I hope she never works with school-aged children again. Substitute teacher for my astronomy class. She was old-fashioned, and her punishments were a little outdated. I came late to class, because I was doing a yearbook assignment, and had a slip from my teacher, that explained why I was late. We had just done a quiz and they were done. but she hadn't collected it. She accused me of cheating, and then made me sit outside the classroom to do the test. She then went back inside, and gave out a new assignment. She said everyone in that classroom was being awful, and made them stay for lunch. She sent me to the principal's office and my class walked out on her. I had a really sweet guy and a few of my friends come in to defend me. It doesn't really seem that bad looking back on it now, but at the time she was not pleasant. Neutron physics professor. When we asked what the best way to study for the test was, he said to take the test, since we would all end up failing the first time anyways. And he averaged the tests, so we could theoretically never get an error, unless we guessed right and studied exactly what he would test on. BTW, this is for grad school, which means that anything lower than a B can get you kicked out. 7th grade, mans didn't understand the concept of this kid is seriously depressed, let him go to therapy halfway through class. He didn't think I was actually depressed, because I was always smiling, fake smile. He would give me detentions without my knowledge, while I was at therapy, and refused to give me the work / instruction, that was said during half the class period, that I was at therapy. He would give me CS, when I would actually make A's. He would call me out / use me as examples, not the biggest fan of unwanted attention. The man literally had a lecture about how kids can't get depressed, because they don't have to deal with adult hardships because of me, and it was basically 10 slides of situations and sentences taken out of context. He finished with a picture of me, using me as an example, and said I was faking for attention and an excuse to skip class. I stood up, and said all the reasons I've been diagnosed with severe depression, none of which were listed in his lecture. My first grade teacher was extremely racist. She practiced something called Sun People and Moon People, that she read in some book. She made half the class Sun People and half the class Moon People. The Sun People consisted of all the African American kids in the class and some of the white females. The rest of the class were the Moon People. The Sun People got to have privileges like extended recess, bathroom breaks, were not required to pick up after themselves, and were treated with respect. The Moon People had to come in early from recess and tidy up the classroom, were not allowed bathroom breaks, and were treated very poorly. I remember one day a boy had an accident, because he wasn't allowed to use the bathroom all day, and she completely lost it. I remember her screaming, "Ah, you are not going to piss on my floor. You are disgusting. Moon People, clean this piss off my floor." And she made all us moon kids get on the floor with spray cleaner and paper towels and clean the floor. We had a new teacher the next day. Long story that I've already posted about elsewhere, so I'll just copy it. My senior year in high school, I had a teacher who was just the worst. To sum up what kind of person she is, it's Dr. So-and-so. Yeah, okay, Dr. High School Computer Apps teacher in the middle of bumfuck nowhere. Anyway, she was supposed to be gone 3 days. Sub comes in, tells us we are supposed to put together a PowerPoint. Okay, cool. So we start doing that. At some point, the sub decides that we aren't doing enough work. So she tells us, "You guys know this is due tomorrow, right? Oh fuck. We're on period scheduling. There's like 30 minutes left in class to do this entire damn PowerPoint." But we buckle down and knock it out. Everyone does. The next day, Dr. Teacher comes in. She says she came back because she heard we had already completed all the work she left. We were like, "Hell yeah, we did. Knocked it out." Then she proceeds to tell us that that assignment was supposed to last for 3 days and wouldn't listen when we tried to tell her what the sub told us. So she says she's going to punish the class and gives us a bunch of bullshit work. Had us handwrite 5-page essays, copy down online articles by hand, and gave us this massive 20-something page pocket to do. I said no. I refused to do any of it. I told her I wouldn't be punished for exceeding expectations. She told me that I would receive 3 Fs for it. Fine. I don't give a shit. The day rolls around to present our PowerPoints, and I make it a point to change nothing about mine. I got 100. Told her I didn't change anything. She said she didn't believe me. Now, the big problem was that she didn't do a ton of teaching, so of those 3 zeros she gave me, we are enough to drop my grade for the semester from a 98 to a 60 something. I got my report card the next week and was fucking livid. I went to the principal to complain, and and he basically told me, look, we've had issues like this before. I can't give you Yura back because you were insubordinate, but I can pass you. Deal. Fine. Sure. I'll take it. Still mad about how the whole thing went down. Fourth grade. My glasses broke, but not too big of a deal. BC, I sat in the front row. She moved me to the back of the class. She would write assignments on the board and wouldn't read it off. Told the girl next to me. She was not allowed to tell me what it said and told me my parents needed to get my glasses fixed. I couldn't make my parents do that. It was rough. Hey Mrs. Johnson. F you. It's been 24 and this still upsets me. My early primary school English language teacher. She was generally rude to everyone, but she hated my guts, especially because I spoke better English than her, and she always marked me wrong for spelling words the British way instead of the American way, even though she knew they were still correct. She would confiscate my personal belongings for no reason, and refuse to give them back. I still remember this one time I was fiddling with my collection of silly bands. I had nearly 50 under the desk, and after confiscating them, she refused to give them back to me because she'd, quote, already mixed them in with all the other ones I've taken, and as I don't know which ones are yours, I won't be giving them back. This was said several days later, after I'd still not gotten them back, and my parents had gone up to confront her about it. My 8-year-old self was heartbroken. She was fired several years later. Locked me in a cardboard box alarm at Ilda on a weekly basis. Kept me in every recess. Screamed at me every day in front of the class, calling me stupid, and yelling at the rest of the class not to act like me. I had ADD, and was suicidal at the time, and was already socially ostracized, because I was much poorer than most of my peers. I was 8. Fuck you, Mrs. Bloom. You're the reason why every time I see a back quote teachers are the best human stuff, it makes me want to punch a wall. I hope you get fucking stomach cancer and die alone and scared. Gym teacher in high school. Rided up and dumb as a rock. Refused to sign off on doctor's notes students would bring in to be excused from gym class. Which was interesting when he did it to a girl on crutches. To this day, one of the biggest assholes I've ever encountered. Or the math professor I had in college, who was a brilliant guy and had degrees and awards coming out his ass, but he was a god-awful teacher and had less than zero people skills. That class was absolutely brutal. I was a lit major. My professor for a course in modern American poetry was the worst instructor I ever had by far. Not because he didn't know the subject, he was a renowned writer and a recent poet laureate, but because he could not teach. Basically, each class consisted of us listening to him read poetry. He had a fine voice, so that was at least enjoyable. However, our entire grade for the course was determined by one final paper. He returned mine with a full page of single-spaced typed comments, which began by noting that I'd failed to consult a book about the sex lives of ancient Romans. He gave me a D, and my overall GPA was around 3.8 at the time. Fortunately, everyone who did poorly, aka all 20 students, was given a chance to write a makeup paper, and I ended up with an A. Still, it burned so badly that when I saw his obit 20 years later, my first thoughts were not kind. Math teacher in 4th grade would always make me take my pants, not including underwear, off until class was over. Once he told me to take my underwear off because I couldn't focus, and I just went to the office. Don't know what happened to him. Probably got fired. In HS, the top 3 shitty teachers were Mr. T, whose freshman daughter walked in on him banging his senior tar. Second was Mr. B, who would chug vodka from a chemistry flask, stagger out of the supply closet, put on a nature film, and pass out on the back counter, and snore louder than the movie. When the bell rang, we just got up and went to our next class with him still snoring away. Lastly, Mr. R, who would go out to his car between classes to get baked, then come back in and spend the entire class hitting on senior girls. Mr. T was fired on the spot and was replaced by a substitute. The other two were fired a few years later, I heard. There were other shitty teachers, both male and female, there who were also rumored to be banging students that quietly got jobs elsewhere right after Mr. T got busted. My 2nd and 5th grade teacher, Mrs. B. She was absolutely awful. In second grade I had picked a fifth grade level book from the library, The Old Willis Place by Mary Downingham, in case anyone's wondering, and she took me outside the classroom, sat me down, and told me to my face that I was not smart enough to understand this book, and that I would absolutely fail if I tried taking a reading test on it. And she didn't say this with any empathy, it was completely cold-blooded, especially for a 7-year-old. Later I scored a 100% on the reading comprehension test, and she tried to convince the vice principal that I cheated, and berated me in front of the class because of this. Thankfully, the VP believed me, and I'm still proud of that 100. She also shouted at me when I wasn't smiling for no reason, and I started crying. She moved up to 5th grade the year I entered 5th grade, and I got stuck with her as my homeroom teacher. She would give me demerits for the smallest things, and even threatened to give me detention for reading a book from the public library during reading time, because it wasn't authorized by the school. Yeah, whatever lady. She would target me over other students, and berate me in front of the class. She also refused to let me go to the nurse's office to get ibuprofen and a menstrual pad, and I almost bled all over my skirt because of it. We also met with the school counselor about this, and she spent the whole meeting accusing me of being a troublemaking brat who didn't listen to orders, which is entirely untrue. If you read any report card of mine from elementary school,